Welcome, we are going to do an LVG theory test. Just installed them, going through them. So don't expect to pass greatly, but what we're doing, mock test, okay. Auto move on to the next question. Yep, okay, let's get started. Oh. Let's go back a bit. You're driving down a long hill, what should you use to prevent the brakes from overheating? Endurance brake, I think. What does this road sign mean? No vehicles over 7.5 maximum authorised. Nice, no vehicles under. No vehicles over overall height. No vehicles over. Yeah, no vehicles over 7.5 ton maximum weight. You're driving a vehicle fitted with anti-lock brakes. What should you do when braking in an emergency? Just apply them the same. Apply firm continuous pressure to the brake and pedal. That's the one. Do not pump it, it pumps it for you, as you should know. Which lane should you use when you're driving on a clear motorway at the speed limit for your vehicle? The left-hand lane. The left-hand lane. Which people would understand that. Hoggers. Many modern vehicles are fitted with an additional near side mirror. What does this help the driver to see? Well, bicycles, curbs, all sorts. The front wheel in relation to the curb, that's the answer up to now. The exhaust, the rear, the distance, the front wheel in relation to the curb. Which vehicles are most likely to be affected by high winds? Well, it's got to be bicycles, isn't it? Oh, hang on. It's going to be curtain-sided vehicles, obviously, because they'll act like a sail. You're travelling behind a moped, what should you do if you want to turn left in a short distance ahead? Let the moped carry on. Stay behind until the moped has passed the junction, that's the one. Wire brushes fitted to this vehicle's wheel arch to clear mud, no, to remove objects from the tyre tread, to stop snow, to reduce spray on wet roads, for other drivers that is, I think that is. So that's obviously tram, which drivers are giving instructions back there, so tram. What should you try to do when you lift a heavy box or suitcase? Get somebody else to do it. Look ahead when the load is secure. Lift and twist, look down, there you go. Look ahead when it's secure. Your lorry is equipped with anti-lock brakes. What is the correct procedure for stopping in an emergency? Apply the foot brake firmly in a pumping action. Nope. Apply the foot brake firmly and continuous until the vehicle has stopped. That is your answer, I think. What would be affected by a vehicle with faulty suspension? Faulty suspension. Road surfaces would be affected. Yeah. Because you will damage them, potholes, all that lot. All the vibrating. What must you have before you can leave a lorry weighing more than 7.5 tons unattended on a verge? What must you have? Well, permission, yeah. The owner's permission. Do you know, I got stuck with this. I'm not sure if it's police, but the owner's permission. What should you do as you approach a zebra crossing? Be prepared to stop in a good time. You're on a wet, level road, driving at 50 mile an hour. What's the minimum time gap you should leave between your vehicle and the one in front?
Your mail, sir.
Oh, thank you, Jeeves. That will be all. 4 seconds. 2 seconds on dry, 4 seconds on wet. Not done this for 6 months, so I've done these four. What colour follows the green signal on a puffin? Oh god, do you know, I'm sure I get this wrong. Puffins and zebra crossings, what follows on a puffin? Green. I'm just gonna go steady red. Steady green, flamber, steady amber. Yeah, steady red. Not sure if I got that one right. Where would you expect to see these road markings? When the vehicle, yeah. At an entrance to a car park, no. On an approach to an arch bridge, maybe. Yep, there you go, that's your answer. At the start of a cycle lane, on the approach to a lifting barrier, on the arch bridge. It's so you can go over single traffic to not put too much weight on the bridge, I suppose. What sign does this mean? Trams only. Well, that's quite easy, isn't it? Trams. Only. Give way to trams. There you go. Nope, it's not. Sorry. It's routes for trams. Sorry about that. Why could it be dangerous to wave people across at a pedestrian crossing? Because there could be something else coming the other way. There may be a vehicle, another vehicle coming. Yep. Who's responsible for making sure that the cargo arrives undamaged? Well, of course, it's yourself. The driver. You're driving a vehicle that's over 17 metres long, 55 feet long. What should you do at a level crossing? Stop before the crossing and phone the signal operator. Okay, that's the actual, because it's too long. Might take too long. Over 55 feet. You're driving a vehicle that's over 55 feet long. Cross over using your horn and hazards. No. Increase your speed. No. Stop before the crossing and lock both ways. Well, that's obvious. It is that. I didn't think that all HGVs stop and do that. I'm sure I've seen longer vehicles than 55 foot just going through. Why are motorcyclists more at risk from other road users? They're easy, they're hard to see. They're easily overlooked. Okay. How would you benefit from forward planning and early recognition of potential hazards? You use less fuel. You'd be able to stop more quickly, use more fuel, reduce journey times. It's do you just want an answer? It's reduced journey times, planning and early recognition. How would you benefit from forward planning to reduce your journey time? Because you wouldn't go in the busy time. While you're driving, you notice your tachograph isn't working. What should you do? Stop immediately. Report it. Continue your journey, but make a manual record, I think. Why is a toucan crossing different from others? Because cyclists can use it. Cyclists can use it. You're driving on a single carriageway. When may you use your mobile phone? Only when you receive, only when you're suitably parked. Come on, we all know that. It's not hard, is it? What danger should you be most aware of if you're driving close to the curb in a busy shopping centre? Well, clipping people's heads, innit? The near side mirror striking the heads of pedestrians. There you go. Straight for that one. You're driving on a motorway. What colour are the reflective studs on the right-hand edge of the carriageway? They're amber. Okay, okay. So they go green when you're coming on, green when you're coming off, red on the left-hand side, white in the middle, amber on the right. Why is it important to avoid overfilling the engine with oil? Because you can blow gaskets. That's all for gaskets, no. It could leave an oil. No, it will increase. It could increase pressure in the engine and cause damage. That's the one. Okey-dokey. A mobile telephone is fitted to your vehicle. When should it be used? When you're stopped in a safe place. Simple, that one. How will your body clock affect your driving between 2 a.m. and 7 a.m? You're most likely to fall asleep at the wheel. That's the one. I'm not going to go any further. You are around. The area around an incident is safe. What's the best way to help an injured person? Leave them where they are. It's safe. Yeah, you should always leave them where they are. It's going to say get them out of the vehicle, it's not. Keep them in the vehicle, okay? Don't move them unless it's very necessary to do so. It could cause more damage. Why do motorcyclists often look over their shoulder? Being a motorcyclist myself, it's your black punch, it's your thingy, isn't it? Black spots. Not pretty. They need to listen. Most cyclists don't have mirrors. Looking over helps and balance. They need to check for their blind spot. They need to check their blind area. Just believe it. Why shouldn't you overtake? When shouldn't you overtake? Sorry. When the speed limits. No. When you're approaching a motorway slip roads. No. When you have to break the speed limits. When you're in view of the road. When you would have to break the speed limit, okay? That's when you shouldn't overtake. You should all know that. Your vehicle breaks down on the motorway. What should you do if you can't get it fully onto the hard shoulder? You have to make a phone call. Call for help. Use the nearest phone call. Okay, okay. Stand at the edge of the place of warning triangle. Yeah. Forget all that hazard stuff. As soon as it's like that, don't put your triangles out. Get to the phone. You're driving a lorry with a sleeper cab. What would, when would a quick sideways glance be helpful? Because your cab swings out further. 60 foot ones, 70 foot ones. Driving around, round sharp ends, yeah. We're driving around a bit of slow travel. When would it be quick sideways glance? Well, yeah. After driving over a pedestrian crossing. No. Yeah, I'm going to go for when driving around sharp ends. Yeah, I have to check that. When traffic is merging from the left or right. Hang on a minute. Make sure I get this one. I think it's that one. We're driving along with a supercar, but when would it be sideways glance be helpful? I can't remember why, but I do think it's that one when traffic is merging from the left or the right. I'm going to go with that one. When would the driver of a car transporter need to be most aware of the front? This is what I thought that one was, because it swings out further when turning. A transporter needs to be most aware of the front overhang of the trailer when turning. How far can a load overhang at the rear before you must use projection marker boards? Oh god, I can't remember this. 3 foot 3 inches. 1 metre. Marker boards. Yep, I'll go for that. How often should the components of a fifth wheel coupling be inspected? Nah, I think it's every 10 kilometres. Okay, I think it's every 10,000 kilometres the fifth wheel needs inspecting. You're often involved in carrying of high value goods. What security measures can you adopt? Vary your routes and rest stops. That's your answer. Always discuss details of your load. Nope. Give lifts. Nope. Keep your journeys to a strict routine. No, because people know where you're going to be. So it's a bit of this and that. Bloody hell, 100 questions there. Right. How often? How is drinking alcohol likely to affect your driving? Let's try and get the answer quicker. You'll feel more confidence, right? You'll feel more confident. Doesn't mean you will be. You'll feel more confidence, but you won't be. Who must you tell when your vehicle collides with a bridge? It's the local authority, I think. Debating the police there, so I could get this wrong. I'll go with the local authority. What should you check for wear or damage on a drawbar unit? On a drawbar unit, fifth wheel kingpin. God, I'm crap, me. Only studied these once, went and passed it, now forgetting them. On a drawbar unit, what should you check? The dot clips and kingpin, okay, fifth wheel coupling, dog clip, kingpin release all. It's the eyelet coupling, I think. A drawbar unit. Which I think it's the towing. Why should you check for wear or damage on a draw? What should you check? The eyelet coupling. I know, I'm rubbish at this. Sorry. Gives you an insight into questions anyway, don't it? Right, anyway. What does air suspension help to protect? Underground services, pipes underground and all that lot. Which will also be damaged by faulty suspension as well. Previous questions. You're trying to resuscitate a casualty who isn't breathing. For how long should you continue? Give up and just forget that, innit? It's not going to be that. Keep trying for 1 or 2 minutes. No, carry on until the ambulance arrives, okay? Carry on. What's the main reason for covering of a skip that you're transporting? To prevent any spillages. Why is it dangerous to follow a large good vehicle too closely? Because you can't see, can you? Your field of vision will be seriously reduced. Okay, ahead. What should you do if you have to leave your vehicle unattended for a very short time? Leave a note on the window, leave the keys, keep the engine, secure the vehicle and lock the doors. You're planning to carry high value goods on a regular basis. Whose advice should you seek? Local crime prevention officer. Okie dokie, because they will tell you what's going on, work and this, that, the other. What should you do if you're taking medication that could affect your driving? Seek medical advice to find out whether it will affect your driving or not. Because the word that there isn't a definitive answer, is it? So seek medical advice. How will gravity affect the laden vehicle going downhill? It's going to push you, isn't it? So the vehicle will use more fuel, stopping distance will be decreased. more braking effort will be required. There you go, obviously. Under EU rules, Brexit, you may drive for up to 9 hours a day. Brexit, could drive more. What maximum may this be increased on 2 days a week? That will be 10 hours. Why are ropes unsuitable to tie down a load of scrap metal? Because obviously metal rope cuts, kind of. Ropes are hard to tie, ropes will loosen and bend, ropes are hard to untie. Ropes can wear and snap. A toucan crossing, pedestrians share the crossing with which other road users? Could have swore we've had a similar question earlier on. Cyclists, toucan play at that game. Where are you most likely to find pedestrians stepping into the road? Okay, right. Shopping areas, wooded areas, one-way streets, motorways. It's going to be shopping areas, obviously. You're making several deliveries. What problems may the decreasing payload cause? So it's going lighter and lighter. You may overload your axle, right? You'll always have variations remaining. You might exceed your curbside. You might overload your axle, meaning when you're taking stuff off, you're going to put heavy stuff over your axle. If you take that stuff off, then your axle's not really taking any weight. I think it's to do with that. Basically, as you're stripping your load off, you're to rearrange your load. You might overload an axle. I'm sure it's that one. You're always. You might exceed your curbside weight. You will damage the rest of the load. It could be you might exceed your curbside weight. You're making several deliveries. What problems may the decreasing payload cause? Yeah, I'll go with you might overload an axle with the stuff that's left on. Under EU rules, your minimum daily rest is 11 hours. On 3 days of the week, this may be reduced to what length of time? 9. What will you need to transport livestock on journeys of less than 40 miles? Practical experience in the care of animals. There you go. That's the one straight away. You're driving along a motorway and see this sign. What does it mean? It's a lane especially for lorries to get in because they go slow. Only lorries and buses are allowed to use that lane. Vehicles fitted with speed limiters. There's an uphill gradient ahead. There you go. Which of these signs means uneven road? We'll go with that one, yeah? Bumpity bump, 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 bump. That one, risk of grounding. That's bridge, that's speed bump, so there you go. The time is 10 a.m. You've been driving non-stop since 6 a.m. Under EU rules, what is the longest you may not drive for without a break? 30 minutes, 4.5 hours. You've done 4 hours, so you can drive for 30 more minutes. You're driving on the left-hand lane in a three-lane motorway. What should you check for before moving into the middle lane to overtake a slower vehicle? Traffic behind in the right-hand lane, returning to the middle lane. Yeah, traffic that's intending. Yeah, it's the first one. Traffic in the third lane, you might think it's all right. Your middle lane's okay, but you've got to take note of that one. There could be vehicles in the fast lane, as they call it. It's not really. The second overtaking lane. Noticing the space in the middle lane for it to move over. So you've got to watch for that. We've all done it. Both outside lane and inside lane, gone to go in the middle lane. What's the speed limit on a dual carriageway when you're carrying a load that is 4.5 metres wide? Do you know what? 4.9, 40. I think it's 35 foot. I'm going to go 45 miles an hour. 14 feet wide. No, I'm going to go 35 miles an hour. I'm not sure about that. Sorry. Let's go through the answers at the end. When should you use your mirrors? As you signal to check the blind spot occasionally before opening the door. Well, it'd be as you signal in it. When should you use your mirrors? Before opening your door. Yeah, before opening your door. In case you hit any bikers or anything like that. What should you do when you overtake a cyclist on a two-way road? Check your mirror to see if you've still got control. Pass close, let no. Go past quickly, no. Leave plenty of room and check your near side mirror before returning to the left. Of course, that's the one. What is the purpose of preheating device? It's for plugs, it's for diesels. It warms up this kind of heated plugs so they can make a spark. So to heat combustion chambers. There you go. To heat the combustion chambers. it's not as high octane as petrol, so it needs a little bit of a push. Your vehicle is fitted with air brakes. What does this mean if a brake warning light shows when you've just started the engine? Air brakes, right, low air pressure, air increased pressure, the parking brake isn't working, air reservoirs, there's low air pressure. You're approaching a bridge that has no height restriction on it. What's the maximum height under the bridge? 16 feet 6 inches. Yeah, I think that's the lowest. A tyre has been replaced on your vehicle. What precautions should be taken when tightening the wheel nuts? Tighten the nuts in a clockwise direction. Fully tighten each nut before moving to the next. Tighten the nuts even like with a torque wrench. Tighten down the nuts with a, there you go, torque wrench. Always torque them down. Rinse the antifreeze be used in the cooling system. Some say all year round, you know. So, I'm going to say it in winter. Oh, bloody hell. People screaming there now. Ooh, you idiots. Easy that one. It is when you've just been studying it. Did these 6 months ago. I'm going to say winter only. I know it's all year round. I'm up it. You hold a full category C license. What does this entitle you to drive? To tow, sorry. Trailer. A trailer up to 750 kg. That is class 7, 7.5 ton, I think. Your loading goods are varying weights. How should they be distributed over the width of the vehicle? Heavy items at the front, light items. Heavy items near the centre line, light items towards the side. Light items at the front, heavy items. Loading your van, I think if I remember it was heavy items straight down the middle, light items on the left hand side of it, which is that one, so let's go for that. You're driving on single carriageway, Lord. What should you do when you see horse riders ahead? It's always got to be really slow down and all that, isn't it? Switch on your vehicle's hazards, check your mirrors, move into the middle lane, signal light to show you're going to pass them. Switch your vehicle's hazard warning lights on. Check your mirrors and prepare to slow down. That's the one. Check your mirrors and prepare to slow down. Because if you immediately go around them, these could be training horses and not used to passing vehicles. You know, so the ignorant drivers sometimes don't think about that. And it causes them to bolt and stuff, so they will let you know when to come past. It's a bit courteous, isn't it? You're driving a long vehicle. What should you be especially careful off before turning left into a main road? Pedestrians on the opposite curb, cyclists on your left, solid white lines in the centre of the road, vehicles directly behind you. Cyclists on your left, I'll go for. What additional training do you need before transporting frozen foods? Packaging procedures, weight distribution procedures, waste hygiene procedures. Yep, that's the one. You've been issued with protective clothing. Who's responsible for its use? You've been issued with protective clothing. Who's responsible for its use? It's obviously yourself, isn't it? Yeah, I'll just say myself. You've been issued it. So, you know what I mean? It's like someone issuing you a pair of trainers. Nobody else is going to come along and tie the laces for you either. What is the mode switch on a tachograph used for? To change to other work, weekly rest periods, illness, who's driving? Oh, A's driving, B's driving, mode switch, other work, I think. I'm not pretending to know all these answers. When will a box van be most affected by side wind? When travelling empty, yeah, because it's very, very light and it can easily be moved. Yep, okie dokie. Your vehicle catches fire while you're driving through a tunnel. What should you do if your vehicle can still be driven? Leave it where it's drive it out, actually, if you can. Drive it out of the tunnel if you can do so, yeah. I find that a bit dodgy, because the faster you go, the more wind it gets, the bigger the fire gets. I do find that, but I'm sure that's the answer. Drive it out if you can. Stop them, walk to an emergency telephone. Yeah, I think it is. What happens at a Toucan crossing? Oh, you're having a laugh. This is the third time I've been asked this. pedestrians and cyclists may use it. What should you do when you're being followed by an ambulance showing a flashing blue light? Stop and let it pass as soon as it is safe to do so. Okie dokie, that's your answer. You're approaching a roundabout. What should you do if there are horses being ridden ahead of you? Give them plenty of room. Okay, there's your next answer. What must you do when you park a lorry weighing more than 7.5 tonnes on a verge for essential loading? Get someone to help you, I think it is. Obtain the owner's permission. Make sure the lorry is always attended. Display an orange badge. Sign the collection. Obtain the orange. Make sure the lorry is already attended. Obtain the owner's permission. Yeah, I'm not sure. See how we do at the end. 16 questions left. When should your lorry coupling system fifth wheel be checked and lubricated? It's regularly. You're driving on the motorway and want to use your mobile phone. What should you do before using it? Check your credit. Might not have enough credit. On your signal. Yeah, you might not have a signal. Stop in a safe place when you can do. It's simple, that one. Come on. What is a buffer lane? A lane for overtaking safely. I think that's the one. A safe lane for vehicles blown off course. Oh no. I think it's a safe lane for vehicles blown off course. The only lane can be used in high winds. Oh, very confusing, because that's what a buffer lane is, a high winds. But it's a safety lane for vehicles that can blown off course. I'm going to go with that one. Why do energy-saving tyres contribute to better fuel economy? They have reduced rolling resistance. That's what it's to do, is it? They have reduced rolling resistance. They allow you to travel at high speeds, they are much easier to manufacture, and heat can disperse. They have reduced rolling resistance. What does this sign mean? You have priority over vehicles from the opposite direction. You're driving an articulated lorry. What could happen if you change to a lower gear while you're going too fast? Well, you could pistons, roof. The engine could stall. The vehicle could jackknife. Well, there you go. You're driving an articulated lorry. Yeah, if you're going too slow, yeah, your back end's going to come forward. If it was a solid vehicle, then that wouldn't happen, but you can jackknife. Your vehicle has collided with the railway bridge. What information must you give to the railway authority when you telephone? The name of the bridge, the number, the make and model of your vehicle, nor the type of bridge, the vehicle, the bridge number. And you won't struggle with that because it actually says it on the sign anyway. Please give this number. When you're carrying other vehicles piggyback, you should use restraints and the parking brake on each vehicle. What else should you use? Make sure the vehicles are sheeted. Place chocks under the wheels. Put the heavy vehicles at the top, warp the vehicle together, use chocks under the wheels, stop them rolling back. You're about to drive a vehicle fitted with hydraulic brakes. What should you check before driving the vehicle? The hydraulic brake fluid level, the power steering, the cooling system, the windscreen washer level. Well, obviously, come on, it's giving you the answer there, isn't
it? You're a male, sir.
Thank you very much, Giles, that will be all. You may go. What are traffic officers authorised to do? They give directions, stop and direct anybody on a motorway. Dealer, these highway officers are only there to stop and direct anyone on a motorway. Who stops on a motorway? Excuse me. You've been stopped at a roadside check. What would the staff from the Environmental Health Department be checking? License entitlements, health, remember, exhaust emissions, tachograph changes, illegal immigrants, so health. The double white line along the centre of the road is unbroken on your side. When may you cross the line? When it's not unbroken. Oh, hang on. To overtake any maintenance vehicle in front. Yeah, that could be it. To overtake pedal cycling travelling at 10 miles an hour or less. Ooh, that could be it. To check it is safe to overtake the vehicle in front. Double white line, no. To overtake a driver travelling at 20. I think that's the one. To overtake any maintenance vehicle. No, because that could be a maintenance vehicle travelling at a speed. But 10 mile an hour rings a bell. Anything at 10 mile an hour, you can do things illegal. You're at the scene of an incident. What would suggest someone is suffering from shock? I think it's a flushed complexion. Being alert, rapid shallow breathing. Very heavy. A flushed complexion. Where can you get advice about carrying out repairs to your vehicle? Workshop manuals. About carrying out the ULA guidance, not the EU directed to health and safety. Workshop manuals. Where can you get advice about carrying out repairs to your vehicle? That's a manual. Yeah, I suppose you'd get advice in the. Go for the workshop manual. You're driving your lorry on the motorway. What should you do when visibility is reduced by heavy rain and spray? Maintain a constant speed. Use main beam lights. Double your dry weather separation distance. Stay in the left hand lane. That's the one. Double your dry weather separation distance. 99. The Driver and Vehicle Standards Agency and the police carry out spot checks for faulty vehicles. What will happen to the vehicle if serious defects are found? It'll stay exactly where it is and not be driven. It will be impounded until a new driver is found. Well, no, because there still could be a problem with the van or lorry. It will be restricted to 30 mile an hour. It will be prohibited from further use until the defects are rectified. That's quite simple, that one. Last question. Which type of load should be secured using chains? Steel plates. That's quite easy, isn't it? Oh, you have reached the end of the test. Just like in the real test, you can now review your answers before ending the test. Okay. Before ending, so what have we got? Number of complete questions. I've done 100. End test. Right, so yeah, so I've done them all, so what now? Review all. There's a button down here, so click that. I don't get. End test. You have attempted all questions. Do you wish to finish the test now? Yeah, finish test. So I've passed. I've got 92%. You need 85. So I'll be alright. Let's quickly see what I failed on. So this one. What must you have before you can leave a lorry weighing more than 7.5 tons unattended? I knew it was police. I said dinner. Bloody said it was the police.
Yeah.
Anyway. This one. What colour follows a green on signal puffing? I knew it was rubbish. I knew I didn't know that one. So it's steady amber. Right. So what colour follows the green signal at a puffing crossing? Steady amber. There's another one. How would you benefit from forward planning and early recognition of potential hazards? You'd use less fuel. You do both, actually. I've done many questions where it says that you reduce your journey time because you're planning it, because you're going to go outside of a busy time to start the other, so that's why I put that. And but anyway, no worries, still passed. So roll down. Others, there's another one. How far can a load overhang at the rear before you must use protection marker board? So it's I put 1 meter and it's 2 meters. Alright, 2 meters load for a marker board. So 2 meters marker boards, that's all you need to remember. 2 meters marker boards. So yeah. Who must you tell when your vehicle collides with the bridge? The police. I even said that, didn't I? Police. Because still passed. Still walking out there with that certificate. So when should antifreeze be used in the cooling system? In winter only, all year round. I did say, didn't I? Don't know if you remember that, bugger. I knew. Why are we always putting it in then, if that's the case? You know what I mean? What must you do when you park a lorry, when you park a lorry weighing more than 7.5 tonnes on a verge for essential loading? I put obtain the owner's permission, and the answer is make sure the lorry is always attended. Last one. You're at the scene of an incident. What would suggest someone is suffering from shock? I put a flushed complexion, and it was rapid shallow breathing. Bit like a dog. there you go. Average performance by topic shows how well you are doing overall for each topic, but not the number of questions attempted. It helps you to find out which topics, or that's basically for the program telling you as you go through them. So, yeah, cool, we done. What's this, get started? No, don't want that. So we're done. Cool, I hope that gives you an insight to the test. Good luck on the day.